It was the great American humorist, Mark Twain, who said, "Loyalty to the country always. Loyalty to the government when it deserves it." If Mark Twain were alive today, I think he would quickly conclude that loyalty to our government lost its due right after 9/11.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so glad that you could join us today for this Wednesday, July 25th, 2001 broadcast. Tyranny is enveloping the globe, and the United States is a shining jewel the globalists want to bring down, and they will use terrorism as the pretext to get it done. Look, we've seen the news stories that you've wanted to blow things up, that you have blown things up, and that you're saying that 4 million of us are going to die and we need martial law and the Associated Press at one of your little drills you had, and that we're aware of who the terrorists are if you pull this. This can stop this Hitlerian Reichstag event. I want to put the toll-free number up for Congress. And I won't want you to believe Alex Jones. I want you to go get these news stories off my website. I want you to call these major newspapers. I want you to find out these statements were true by the White House about preparing for martial law. And I want you to let them know that if there is any terrorism, we know who to blame.
We have a Congress that has an approval rating that is no longer detectable by current technology. A growing public awareness that the war of drugs has been manufactured by the CIA and organized by the DEA.
If you want to collect content on the American, then a court order is issued.
They are not, the National Security Agency is not listening to Americans' phone calls, and it is not reading Americans' emails. None of these programs allow that. As a matter of fact, the Patriot Act and that part of that 702 says it is expressly prohibited by law that you can read and wholly surveil domestic email traffic in the United States.
Even if you're not doing anything wrong, you're being watched and recorded, and the storage capability of these systems increases every year consistently by orders of magnitude. You simply have to eventually fall under suspicion from somebody, even by a wrong call, and then they can use the system to go back in time and scrutinize every decision you've ever made and attack you on that basis to sort of derive suspicion from an innocent life and paint anyone in the context of a wrongdoer.
Government law enforcement, namely the FBI, NSA, DHS, and TSA, illegally read our correspondences and listen to our communications while sexually fondling our families, all in the name of national security, which pitifully adds up to national insecurity. We have a military that is exponentially raping female soldiers, wives of soldiers, and any female unfortunate enough to live near a military base.
View, I don't know how you can say that having 19,000 sexual assaults and rapes a year is discipline and order. I do not understand how you can say that of those 19,000 cases, to only have approximately 2,400 even reported, because the victims tell us that they are afraid to report because of retaliation and the blame they will get and the scorn they will get from their colleagues, is order and discipline. And I really cannot understand how 2,400 cases, only 240 of which go to trial, can be result in you believing that that authority is giving you discipline.
There is something that seems odd about the power to reject findings that came out of a jury in the absence of some major obvious problem.
Meanwhile, the quiet rollout of Bill Clinton's 1033 program, mushrooming into the NDAA, has been building the militarized police force Goliath, while genuine usurpers beat down a path to the highest branches of our government.
I welcome this kind of examination, because people have got to know whether or not their president's a crook. Well, I'm not a crook.
What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea. A new world order.
The problem of the Bush presidency will be the emergence of a new international order.
Within the next 4 years, we will see the emergence of a new international order.
The beginning.
We have confidence because freedom is the permanent hope of mankind. The hunger in dark places. The longing of the soul. When our founders declared a new order of the ages, when soldiers died in wave upon wave for a union based on liberty, when citizens marched in peaceful outrage under the banner Freedom Now. They were acting on an ancient hope that is meant to be fulfilled.
After 1989, President Bush said, and it's a phrase that I often use myself, that we needed a new world order. And instead, it looks like we got a lot of disorder.
The international order that we have worked for generations to build. Ordinary men and women are too small-minded to govern their own affairs. That order and progress can only come when individuals surrender their rights to an all-powerful sovereign.
Fortunately for Mark Twain, he died just 3 years before the bankers finally got their hands on our economy, and Banker Paun and U.S. President Woodrow Wilson oversaw the ratification of the 16th Amendment to the United States Constitution. I'm sure the obscenity of its declaration would not have been lost on Mr. Twain. The Congress shall have power to lay and collect taxes on incomes from whatever source derived, without apportionment among the several states, and without regard to any census or enumeration. The resulting Internal Revenue Service became so bloated with hubris after 102 years that it now gives promotions to IRS employees that cheat on their own taxes. In approximately 60% of the willful violations, the IRS managers refuse to fire the guilty employees. And the directors of the Internal Revenue Service target patriotic Americans now, as if they were the enemy. And if Mark Twain were alive today, well, I would be ashamed to explain to him the abject putrefaction that wafts through the halls of the Environmental Protection Agency. I would ask him to please cover his ears while I explain to the rest of America that EPA employees are regularly reprimanded for defecating in the hallways of the Denver, Colorado regional office, and that the watching of pornography on government computers during work time at the EPA has become so commonplace that EPA employees have been caught watching hours of porn, harassed the female employees, and were then promoted.
It says 2010. When did we discover he's looking at the porno?
I believe the information came to us within the last 6 months. We acquired that information.
But something needs to be changed when people are breaking the law, when you have this GSA 14 sitting there abusing his position, his salary, ripping off the taxpayers. Somebody told me he's still on the payroll. Is he on the payroll, Mr.
Yes,
Warren?
He is.
This is so offensive. It's unbelievable.
I guess I'm thankful that Mr. Twain isn't alive to see all this, knowing that there was a time when America wasn't a shell of its former providence and glory. As dismal as it may seem, Mr. Twain wouldn't want you to forget America when he said, "It's not the size of the dog in the fight, it's the size of the fight in the dog." John Bound for Infowars.com.